Welcome back. As I told you earlier today, we're going to talk about budgeting. How do you budget on this festive season? Budgeting refers to the process on how you determine your money and how you're gonna spend your money. But as I told you earlier today, we are joined by Tabitha Kibugi, who is a financial analyst. Welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah, and to kick us off, Tabitha, how is it advisable to budget and why?
Thank you for that question, Joy.
Yeah.
It is very important to and advisable to budget for many reasons. But one of the reasons is so that you do not empty and finish the little that you have, mm-hmm. or even the much that you have. You see, without a budget, all you do is spend, spend, spend. Mm-hmm. You do not get to know how much you were supposed to spend and how far you have come with your spending. So without a budget, mm-hmm. your 10 shillings that you have, mm-hmm. will all end up in spending and you'll have nothing for tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So budgeting makes sure we have for today, mm-hmm. and something for tomorrow.
Oh. Right. And I understand there are budgeting processes and techniques.
Yes.
Can you tell us more?
There are several and very many budgeting techniques and processes that are used.
Okay.
But I will zero down to two that are very important and that we can all use.
Mm-hmm.
There is up-down. And mm-hmm. the down up.
Yeah.
So the up down is where you already have your resources,
mm-hmm.
you have your money, and now you decide how to spend it.
Mm-hmm.
The down up is where you first start with your needs going up. You start with the needs and then you look for the allocation.
Mm-hmm.
Now what I advise for everyone is a combination of the two.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes the up down might be too extravagant because
mm-hmm.
you will sometimes find like you have the money
yeah,
so you
right.
can spend it,
yeah, sure, yeah, sure.
And sometimes the down up
mm-hmm.
can be too tight on you,
mm-hmm.
you might especially like in the season that we are in,
yeah.
if you work with a down up, sometimes you might want to get an extra pair of shoes because it is
sure,
a Christmas season,
sure.
but it is too limiting because
mm-hmm.
the down up is limiting. It is especially used when you're trying to cut on finances, especially
mm-hmm.
when companies are downsizing and all that, they use
mm-hmm.
the down up.
Mm-hmm.
So what I recommend is have a negotiated budgeting.
Mm-hmm.
That is, you use the down up and the up down.
Mm-hmm.
That goes back to the first question that you asked.
Okay.
We must budget.
All right,
yes.
All right. Thank you for that. And to explain more about that,
mm-hmm.
you know, this is a youth station,
mm-hmm.
and actually youth should budget.
Yes.
Isn't that right?
It is right.
Yes. And why should you just check when budgeting for this festive season? What are the main priorities that youth should check when budgeting for this festive season?
Good question, Joy, especially
mm-hmm.
when you say and you talk about the
youth. Yeah.
We must acknowledge first that at the stage where one is a youth, they are in the stage where they are trying to build their wealth.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the youths today would not have not reached the stage where they have more than enough
mm-hmm.
to just use however.
Yeah.
And you realize even the ones that look like they have more than enough
mm-hmm.
are very keen on how to budget.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in this particularly festive season,
mm-hmm.
there are so many activities,
yeah.
so many events
yeah.
to attend. In fact,
yeah,
if you
sure.
look at the social media platforms, you will see so many activities for the youths to attend.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the youth need to budget in this festive season
mm-hmm.
so that one, they can be able to enjoy the festive season so that it does not come with a lot of bad and negative energy.
Yeah, sure.
You still get to enjoy the festive season,
mm-hmm.
but also you get to spend your money wisely.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
So the youth need to first of all budget.
Mm-hmm.
So they look at what they have
mm-hmm.
and then they look at the festive season. How memorable would I want this festive season to be?
Mm-hmm.
I believe, Joy, even you in your
yeah,
plans.
Sure.
You
actually,
want to enjoy.
I started my festive season back last week.
Wow,
yeah.
Good for you.
Yeah.
So you want to make sure that your remembrance of the festive season of December
mm-hmm.
is a good memory.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to budget for it. You need to have the resources for
mm-hmm.
it. So budgeting, but also making sure that this is not just an ordinary December.
Mm-hmm.
So making it not an ordinary December
right.
means that the youth have to factor in everything.
Mm-hmm.
Part of it would mean you put down everything
mm-hmm.
that you want to achieve. Where
mm-hmm.
do I want to go?
Mm-hmm.
Whom do I want to go with?
Yeah.
Do I have to go?
To go, exactly.
All right?
Exactly.
And if I have to go, how mm-hmm. much mm-hmm. will it cost me? Mm-hmm. Everything must have the cost mm-hmm. accompanied to it, yeah, so sure. that then the mm-hmm. budgeting process is complete. Mm-hmm. Because just writing that I would want to go to Naivasha, mm-hmm. I would want to go to Dubai, yeah. is not enough. Yeah. Put the cost, mm-hmm. then work around it. Do mm-hmm. I have the money? Mm-hmm. Can I achieve it? Mm-hmm. So if we cannot achieve it, Joy, I think we will just stay in the house and enjoy with the rest.
That's not good. But yes. but to say about budget, which part of you is in charge of this? But is it the judgmental self or the loving yourself? You know, we are youths.
Well, I'd go with the truth is mm-hmm. around the Christmas or the festivities season, mm-hmm. we go with the loving self.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
but
sure.
the truth is we mm-hmm. should go with the judgmental self, mm-hmm. where your mind is at mm-hmm. work, mm-hmm. so that your emotions do not carry you, mm-hmm. Do not take over your mm-hmm. judgment of what to do. Mm-hmm. So if your mind is at work, mm-hmm. you will do the math that is determined by what do I have, mm-hmm. what can I spend, okay. and is January coming?
Sure.
Because in sure, all these January festivities, January should be always in at the mind. Back of your mind. Mm-hmm. What do I have, mm-hmm. what can I spend, mm-hmm. and will I be begging mm-hmm. in January?
Exactly.
Now with all that, then we can plan for the month, mm-hmm. for this month and for the festivities. Mm-hmm. So the mind, the logical part of us mm-hmm. should be at work more than the,
so the judgment
enjoyment,
themselves.
As they call uh-huh. it.
Yeah,
yes.
yeah, sure.
Yes.
And actually, I understand you are a parent. Mm. And how should parents engage their youths in this festive season?
Mm. I love your question, Joy. I'm mm. not a parent to a youth, mm-hmm. but I have an answer to your question. Mm-hmm. First of all, I think parents should have a conversation with their youths about spending.
Right.
And I think this conversation should not start now when mm-hmm. we want to spend. Mm-hmm. Because the youth might not understand that mom does not want to. Mm-hmm. They will think
yeah,
mom
sure.
does not want, but
sure.
it is because mom does not have the resources
sure.
to do this. Because mm-hmm. January is coming, school mm-hmm. fees is coming and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe strongly that parents should have this conversation mm-hmm. way earlier. But mm-hmm. even if it has not been held, the conversation, we can mm-hmm. still have it today.
Mm-hmm.
We talk about, we are in the festivities period, mm-hmm. and these are the things that we want to do as a family.
Yeah.
Want to go and visit granny, mm-hmm. want to go for a holiday as a family.
Mm-hmm.
You want to new clothes, Christmas clothes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure.
And this is our pool of resources.
Mm-hmm.
So can we prioritize?
Mm-hmm.
Priorities are what are going to help us budget as a family.
Mm-hmm.
So we will check what must we do.
Mm-hmm.
So what must be done has to be done first. Rent has to be paid.
Mm-hmm.
We need school fees for January.
Yeah,
we
sure.
need all this.
Mm-hmm.
But we also need to enjoy the festivities. So what must we do?
Mm-hmm.
We do what we must first.
Mm-hmm.
And then we do what is not absolutely a must
mm-hmm.
next. And ensure that the period is full of merry
mm-hmm.
as much as our resources can fund.
Mm-hmm.
So the function that the role that parents have to play
mm-hmm.
is to have a conversation
mm-hmm.
with their children and make them understand this
mm-hmm.
is what we have
mm-hmm.
in terms of the resources
yeah.
and this is what we can afford.
Yeah.
Now can we work around it
mm-hmm.
as a family?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow, that's great. And actually we should bear in mind on the youths that are disabled.
Oh yes.
How do they celebrate, or how can you just advise them to celebrate their holidays? Because you know this budget is everywhere to every person.
Yes.
Yeah. So just tell us more.
You've touched a very
controversial aspect.
Well, touchy
yeah.
issue.
Yeah.
And I appreciate you for even bringing it up, because
yeah.
sometimes they look as they are disadvantaged,
mm,
as though they're
sure,
disadvantaged.
Sure.
So the ones that are disabled or
mm-hmm.
the ones that are abled differently,
mm-hmm.
first I believe every family should
mm-hmm.
consider them as part of the festivities that we are all enjoying.
Right.
So they should, the first thing I think all families should do is that they should not set them apart.
Mm-hmm.
They should include them in their budgets.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, I would advise them to also be positive minded.
Mm-hmm.
See, sometimes it's hard to incorporate
yeah.
someone into the festivities when they're
mm-hmm.
already looking down upon
mm-hmm.
themselves. So
mm-hmm.
the second thing is that I would encourage them to participate as much as possible.
Mm-hmm.
So there is the societies and families to include them
mm-hmm.
and they themselves to be part of it.
Mm-hmm.
Now for those that are working,
mm-hmm.
They can always find, for example, if you're going for holiday,
mm-hmm.
find a place that is friendly
mm-hmm,
to your
you.
Kind of disability.
Yeah.
Because if you go to a place where say if you are physically challenged, you cannot walk. If you go to a place like a pool, you might feel like everything is not working for you, right?
Yeah, sure.
But you can find another way of having fun. Mm-hmm. Like you cannot plan for hiking because that would be a challenge for you.
Mm-hmm.
But you can find something else that works for you. Mm-hmm. Anywhere where there is eating, anywhere where there is a lot of socializing.
Mm-hmm.
So I would advise that the ones that are physically challenged or have disabilities of different sorts, that they choose the kind of, whatever they will choose to enjoy their festivities is something that is friendly to their to themselves and to their bodies and to their minds, so that they also get to enjoy it and don't feel like they were left out.
Mm-hmm.
So the greatest role on them is to make sure that whatever they choose is what works
for them.
They should communicate it. Sometimes families have a way of excluding them, so they can speak it out. Last time we went to a beach and I could not have fun because I cannot participate in the activities there. How about we try this? Last time we all went hiking and I had to wait for you guys down at the mountain because I can't go hiking. How about we try something else? I think they should also try and find and encourage the people around them to participate in activities that are friendly to them, so that they also feel the magic of the festivities.
Yeah, sure. Yes. Thank you. Thank you about that. And actually, let us talk about savings. You know, we need to save because we do not predict the future. And are people late to save for this festive season? Is it too late to save this the salary that you have or that you're getting this coming month? Is it really late to save?
Well, they say that the December salary is not for the Christmas season.
It is
for the next month. I strongly believe that for by the time we get to the this festive season, we should have saved for it. So our savings should have started in January, depending, especially depending on how big your spending is, your expenditure during this period is.
Sure.
On the question of if it is late, it is a little late because the
Happy New Year is coming.
Well, Happy New Year comes with happy school fees.
Children
are going to Form One and they are joining universities. Rent has to be paid. We have to go to work and we do not want to cry in January come the new year, okay? So I think the place of saving is very important. Do you know what, Joy? I also think that even in this festive month, we can still save.
We should
save. We usually save up to November, and we will start again in January. We should plan to save even in December, so that January is not as hectic and as dry and sunny as it really is. So I think, and then I think in this time, we should not spend all our savings in the festivities.
Actually, I wanted to talk about that point. Is having fun with the savings advisable? Because, you know, we saved, and something, you know, you cannot predict about the future. And something just happens, or an emergency about hospital bills and all that. Is it advisable really to spend on your savings?
My advice would be this, Joy. Spend what had been saved for the festivities. Do not spend your savings. When we are saving, we should save X amount because Christmas will come. Because December will come, all right? So if there was no such fund, if you use whatever else you had spent and then the new year comes and an emergency comes, then it will be hard to work around it. But then that will allow me to touch just a little bit on the savings. When we are saving, we should be saving with those things in mind. An emergency fund should be different from your normal savings. So that no matter the situation, I will never touch this unless it really is an emergency. Okay? When you have removed all your daily, monthly expenditure, there should be the savings that you have. And with the constant reminder and thought that Christmas, New Year, Jamhuri, and December at large is coming, I think we should all be saving towards it, just as we would save for a trip, for school fees. For all that, we would not take school fees money to go for a trip with. So I also think we should not spend all our savings on this. That is if you had not saved specifically for the festivities. If you're going to spend what you had saved, just a small, the tiniest portion should be spent on the festivities.
Probably the 1% of it.
Do you know why, Joy? Tomorrow we will not remember the festivities.
Yeah, sure.
So do not spend everything that you have worked so hard to save on the festivities. Just a small portion. And then we make sure tomorrow we are smiling, not crying.
Yes. And to wind up, how can one have fun without money? You know, because we are not so that blessed, let us say, let us put it that manner. But how can we have fun without money?
Good question, good question. Especially
because,
the youth.
Yeah, and because people call it that having fun is all about money, spending and all that.
I believe there's several ways that we can have fun without spending money. One, we can visit our parents instead of going to Naivasha and Mombasa and Dubai.
Right.
And more often than not, you can find that our parents will fund the eating. Secondly, we can make merry and have games just by ourselves in our houses. For example, we can play board games. You don't need to spend money. You can play games, the mind-boggling games, without spending money. We can participate in activities that are around us. For example, if you belong to a church or a community group, and they have planned for an event in the community, say having fun with the kids around or the less fortunate or less privileged, you can go and have fun with them. You'll get to use your skills, have fun with them, encourage someone, and you'll still have fun, okay? So if we do not have the resources, there's still so many other ways that you can create fun by yourselves. Invite friends over. Pool resources, all right? If we have 10 friends and we put a movie in our house, we will still have fun. And we will not have to spend a lot. Or we will all pull our resources and be able to bring up something that we'll still have fun, but we'll not spend too much. Because sometimes we use too much to get the same thing that we would have had in the house. If we can cook in the house rather than buy out, that's another way. You can, because buyouts are expensive. They're expensive. In these days of asking them to actually be brought in the house, that's expensive. But cooking in the house, pulling resources together, that will work.
Wow, that's great. And I just give you 5 seconds. What do you advise the youths out there to how on budget on this festive season?
Spend what you have already saved for. Do not spend what you do not have.
Wow. We had Tabitha Kibugi, a financial analyst. Wow, thank you very much for coming and for just giving us and telling us about how to budget on this festive season. Well, that is you youths you had out there, and also parents and all people who watched tonight. I will tell you, just have a budget on how to spend on this festive season. That's what we had for you. My name is Joy Ndega. Have a blessed night. God bless.